have had fourth quarter rallies before this season to get victories, but can they follow this one up with a victory? I have to see against the Giants. Hey, how are you, folks? Jason Horwitz, NFL.com's Pat Kerwin. Glad to be with you. It is 5-6 Chicago at home to 7-4 New York, of course, coming off the terrible game against the Vikings. We'll get into that in a sec, but let's start with Chicago. And last week down 34-20. They were only at that point because of the way Devin Hester played in the third quarter. Rex Grossman rallied them back for the victory. They won in overtime. But three times this season, they've had big fourth quarter comeback wins. They followed it up the next week with a loss. What makes Bears fans, or what would you say to Bears fans to make them think this is different?
Be leery of your football team. You haven't won two in a row all year, so I think you got to. They're not able to sustain excellence. Why? Because the backbone of this football team is the Chicago Bear defense, and they don't stop the run the way they used to. They don't dominate opponents. They don't create turnovers. They don't do the things that let you play a quarterback like Rex Grossman, who doesn't really play well every week. The defense was winning games. The defense doesn't show up anymore like that. It all starts up front. They've lost the infrastructure of those tackles, the guys that made this thing solid, that Urlacher could fly around. It's not as good as it used to be inside. Go watch the tapes. The Chicago Bear defense isn't what they used to be.
But people have been running on the Bears, and
sure,
that's tougher this week for the Giants because they're not going to play with Brandon Jacobs. Derek Ward, he did practice on Wednesday, still listed as questionable, may start, but you got Derek Ward and Ruben Jones. That's not the tandem that scares you as a defense.
You know, it's good enough in my book to play in a game like this. If you know you're playing against a team that's given up 4.5 yards a carry, so Ruben Drones and Derek Ward combined for 3.9 a carry, it's still good enough to set up play action. It's still good enough to move the chains. It's still good enough to give you what you want to do. Because if you want Shockey to play effectively, and this is a game that Shockey should be able to do a pretty nice job of catching the football, it all for him is off play action. Don't show him three-step drop where everybody can drop in and fake blitzes like the Eagles did and all the things that caused problems. Well, the Vikings were even better at it, of faking blitzes and then dropping back into coverage and forcing Eli to mistakes. Pull the ball out of the running back's stomach and do it off play action. You'll get the tight end down the field.
All right, let's get into Eli Manning because last week he had tied a career high with four interceptions. People by now know that three of those were taken back for touchdowns, and that was against the Vikings. This now on the road. And, you know, even this week, general manager Jerry Reese said that Eli has become skittish. He's taking criticism from every possible angle.
Yeah, I don't agree at all with Jerry saying that about his quarterback. This is your quarterback. You got to stick together as a family that doesn't do anything to be productive or keep everyone together. It's not the kind of reinforcement Eli needs at this time. Remember this about Eli Manning. He's in his fourth year. He took a team to the playoffs two of the first 3 years. If he takes him to the playoffs this year, and I think he will, he certainly is in a position right now to do that. Then he'll just did something his brother never did. Take a team to the playoffs three of the first 4 years. You stick together in this situation. You don't come apart at the seams. I was disappointed in Jerry saying
it. A lot of people would say that, at least Eli's critics would say he's done that. They've done that despite Eli Manning. But
they don't know what they're talking about.
Right.
Let me just say a couple of things here. You got Plaxico Burress who can't run anymore. He's go check his yards per catch. It's 8 yards a catch, so there's no vertical threat from him. Amani Toomer can't run anymore, so there's no vertical threat from him. Everyone's crowding the line and keeping this whole thing in front of him. It's tougher and tougher to find cracks to throw the football. Eli will rebound. He's a Manning. He'll do fine in this thing. Watch him come back and have a good game against the great Chicago Bears.
All right, well, nobody's calling him the great Chicago Bears.
I'm not.
Nobody else is either. Let's throw all the numbers into the computer, get the AccuScore prediction. 10,000 tests. The computer says the Bears are going to win. Pat?
Great. I love that computer. Don't get one for Christmas. I'm not. The New York Giants will rebound and win this football game.
Can you get one for Hanukkah?
Sure, I'll get you one.
All right,
you're
the Horwitzes will get one for Hanukkah. Folks, the game starts at 4:15 p.m. Eastern. For more on this or any other here in Week 13, be sure to stay with CBSSports.com. Watch everything else on the CBS Audience Network. For Pat Kerwin, I'm Jason Horwitz. It's time to go buy some presents. No, you're early. Now you take care.